Right. Here we go. Let's see if it works here. Meeting is now streaming live on Facebook. All right. Well, hello everybody. You're here live with my good buddy Mark Lethierry. And hey everybody. I know everyone's probably bombarded with so many live videos right now, but I think for myself, I needed to do something to stay motivated. I enjoy talking about music and playing guitar, and it's pretty low on the list of necessities right now. But anyway, hi Mark.
Hello. Hey, I changed my audio. Does this still sound okay?
Yeah, it sounds good.
Okay, what if I do guitar things?
I hear it.
Okay, I just use the AT instead of the here. So that's that. And then here's my computer mic. You can tell me which one sounds better.
What about the voice?
This is me talking. I'm talking through the internal microphone now. Now I will talk through the AT. Talking through the AT. This is me.
AT is much louder and clearer.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. There we go.
Yeah. Hey, where'd you get that mic?
Some dude.
Yeah.
I beat him up outside of a guitar center. I used to have two of these. What happened to the other one?
You had two?
Yeah. Did I get? I maybe I gave you the other one back. I think
Think you did, and I gave it to Mark Cuthbertson.
How do we see if anyone's watching?
Well, let's see. It's if you open Facebook, you can actually see.
Okay, I see.
Yeah. Anyway, let's see. Oh,
Oh, there we go.
hey, Nick Granville from New Zealand says, "Hey, cats,"
Oh, there we are.
and yeah.
Whoa, now I'm
Everyone says,
hearing
sounds
myself.
great. All right. Justice is stoked for this. Sounds great. Good. All right. Kenny says, what's up, Noel? Thanks for being on. Be safe. Hey, thank you for saying thank you. Yeah, so I was just one of my friends sent me some stuff to record a few days ago, and I just didn't feel like it. And I don't know if you've experienced any of this, Mark, but
Was it bad? No.
like no, I didn't even listen to it. I didn't even
Just
like
kidding.
I felt bad because I didn't reply like for a couple of days, and I finally replied. It's like I'm really sorry. I just haven't been really motivated musically much because I think maybe a lot of musicians can relate. Maybe they can't. Maybe I'm weird, but I thrive on the sort of the crowds, I guess, the people, the reality that people appreciate what you do. I mean, that's the whole reason why I started playing guitar in the first place, is because, hey, people thought I was, I was good at it and people liked it. And, I don't know if that made any sense.
Was Ji Young just yelling at you just then?
No, she's yelling at the kids, probably.
Oh.
Could you hear that? I can't hear that.
Yeah, it's those hi-fi mics you got, dude. Space station over there.
No, but anyway, like I've been motivated to do other things since, we're not, really not playing much. I painted the kitchen cabinets, and those
Oh,
look
that's
cool. You want to
good.
see that? I can look at it on my phone. And then I helped a buddy build a chicken coop. And I've been doing stuff like, preparing for the hopefully not coming, but maybe coming zombie apocalypse.
Well, yeah. I mean, you know what? Yeah. So here's what I was doing. I was like, I got kind of inspired to like start doing more baritone stuff, like trying to write that project, and then I got done these things, and then I immediately went into like, holy crap, I need to like prepare like things, so it was like it's today I spent all day like trying to get this live stream thing to work, so because I'm thinking that that might be like a thing that I'll probably start doing if we can't play live or do actual clinics or anything like that, because I'm not really can't really interact with people on a personal level at this moment. So I like spent like 6 hours trying to get this thing to get together, and I was like, oh man, like that was 6 hours I could have continued to be creative. Now it's just like, I'm kind of like, want to just drink a beer and sit outside.
I know, right? You know, there's some good, I've met a whole bunch of neighbors, which,
yeah,
that's cool.
Are you keeping like 6 feet though? Like,
yeah, 6 feet. Okay, yeah. I've actually, I've got a batch of Doomsday IPA in the fermenter right now. And I've invited every neighbor I've seen to come out and bring a lawn chair. We'll hang out 6 feet apart and we'll awesome. Sample it in next week.
I was creative yesterday. You know, Ben Eller.
Yeah.
He and I put together this goofy little version of Teen Town that we called Quarantine Town.
Nice.
So it was an excuse to learn that song again.
That's great. Fun,
you know, are we gonna both play to the same time? How's it going?
You were faster. it's been a long time since I played that. Love that tune. Are you soloing on the same chords?
I didn't even solo.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't
time. Let's start with A.
It's first chord.
Was it F? C. Okay, so it goes C13, then A13, and then
D,
and then F, and then. If you treat all those as Lydian dominants, it sounds pretty cool. Is that what you do?
Sure. Well, I would if I, yeah.
So.
The hardest part for me was getting that first lick down. I was doing it like Travis, like the, you know, the country style. Like that.
Did you just do it in C?
Yeah, the first one's in C.
Not D? Uh-uh. All right, whatever.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Great melody.
Hey, if you get a little closer to your mic, can I is it gonna be louder?
It's coming out there. Here, I'll just turn it up. References. Whoa.
Oh, yeah. That's loud.
Is that nuts?
I don't know. Sounded good to me. Yeah, sounds fine to me. I actually can't tell how loud my mic is compared to yours because I've got my turn. I can't hear myself, but I know I'm talking.
I've got like a little bit of myself and my logic thing here, mm-hmm. which I might just turn down.
So anyway, I just saw Chad said, I'm so much louder than you. Oh, some Jim says better now. So, okay, cool. All right. So, you know, I was looking at my old photos on my phone, just kind of scrolling through. And, you know, as I go back to early March, you know, before, you know, this stuff got kind of weird. And then February where everything was still, you know,
yeah,
like, you know, it was still on joke level, you know, we're all making jokes about it, you know,
you
instead
still
of
are making jokes. You just have,
well, I know, like, I'm
just kidding. He's not,
I do enjoy humor. I actually, like, I have a pretty sick sense of humor. I enjoy the,
you heard it here first, folks,
the dark humor. Yeah. The things I think of, I don't post usually.
Smart.
But yeah, Mark and I hang out 3 days a week at Daystar, which
it's
is
a lot.
One of our regular gigs. So I have to tell you this story, everybody. So Mark and I are good friends because, well, about what, 10 years ago, 12 years ago, you started playing at Daystar?
Yeah. Well, 10 years ago.
10 years ago? Okay. I started like 12 or 13 years ago.
Right.
And then, we both play guitar at this TV station, Daystar, Christian TV network in, here in town. And I felt like we had a lot in common. You know, we're both DFW-based guitar players. And now he's a world-famous guitar player. But anyway, so we liked a lot of the same music. Like, he was into King's X and a bunch of 80s hair metal, which was really from my era, not his era. So I was, like, kind of surprised that someone that was, like, 10 years younger than me listen to the same stuff that I did.
That band transcends a lot, though.
Yeah, King's X especially, yeah. And then I found that
here, I'll do background music for you.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe summertime will kill the viruses.
Keep talking.
Yeah. So Mark had a lot of the same influences that I did, musically speaking. But he also had this other music, these other musical influences that I didn't have, which really was interesting to me. The sort of neo-soul, black gospel kind of thing that I had not explored very much, even though where I grew up, my dad is a music minister, we had classical music and gospel music, but not the kind of gospel music that Mark had really checked out and dug into quite deeply. And my background, rock and also jazz, I had some like maybe bebop stuff that maybe Mark didn't have. So I felt like we shared ideas a lot together. So not just jokes, not just goofy jokes, but also like licks and harmonic concepts and stuff like that. So I felt like we've sort of been each other's teacher a little bit. Wow. What do you think about that?
I mean, I think you've showed me a lot more than I've showed you, but
what?
Well, it's cool to share. It's great to share stuff because
yeah.
I mean, when we first met, I was kind of like knee deep in a lot of this kind of soul gospel guitar stuff, which I still do, but I think it's kind of like, it's not, maybe not so overt, but I remember when we were first kind of, I was showing you all this stuff and I think I hipped you to a lot of players like Jonathan Dubose and Eric Wall and Jairus Mose and Justin Gray.
Justin,
we should
Gray.
Get him on the show. All these guys that I was just checking out and meeting firsthand, which was pretty cool, like kind of before, you know, it sort of became this like thing on Instagram or whatever. It was like, right. You know, you could actually meet people and, you know, play with them or whatever. But yeah, man, I mean, I think you definitely hit me to a lot of tonality stuff and modal stuff, which I knew was out there, but I think maybe I was afraid of it because I didn't know how to use it in a way that made sense to me musically. Like, you know, now I feel like I can employ it and it makes my music still feel like my music. It just has like, you know, an extra vibe that maybe it didn't have.
I can tell you the one of the earliest examples, you showed me this lick, this gospel lick that was like,
okay.
C diminished triad.
Yeah, that's from, I got it from my piano player friend, Chan Horton.
Yeah, so that's just like a triad player. C diminished triad to B flat major triad, right? And that's like a pretty common like thing in a hymn, like. You know, I can't remember.
Sure.
Yeah. But the sort of tonality, sort of jazz guy in me, I was like, okay, what is that? Like, usually diminished chords scare people, but in the context of B flat, it's like basically a tri-pair, right? C diminished triad to B flat major, and then another C diminished triad to B flat again. You could keep it going. You know, just all of that. And between those two triads, it's six notes, and it happens to fit the, if you think of it as a B flat, it's the fifth mode of melodic minor starting on B flat. So it'd be E flat melodic minor. Yeah. So the improv guy in me was like, okay, if I stick those two triads in a, let's see if I can.
Cool. Yeah. Yeah. Somehow the hi-hat showed up. I don't know.
Oh yeah, it's in my looper. It's in the loop.
Whoa.
Was it too loud? Was the hi-hat too loud?
No, I just noticed it. I was like, your loop pedals come with hi-hats?
Yeah, so instead of like freaking out over this C diminished, like what do you play over that? And then I was like, okay, B flat, I know how to do that. And then another freak out, oh crap, C diminished again. And then B flat, I know how to do that. Instead of thinking of two different things, I'm like, well, it's really a cadence, like a vamp in one sound, like tension resolution in that sort of alternate B flat sound.
Yeah, I mean, I would play the bluesy stuff over the first half, and then when it came, to turn around.
Yeah. Interesting that you should say bluesy stuff. Because in my sort of blurb, I talked about that jazz sandwich, that jazz one sandwich. I don't know if that made any sense to anybody,
I didn't see that.
but that's a picture from like, I was scrolling back in my pictures. I saw that. It's in my whiteboard at my studio at UNT. And that's another thing. I'm really inspired by my students at UNT because like every lesson, I'm like, oh, I didn't, I have this new idea of like how to teach or how to learn. And then, sorry, every time I say words that exist in the movie Billy Madison, I get distracted.
Shampoo is better.
Are you here to teach or are you here to learn? That's
Focus.
me at UNT, right? So anyway, so that's B flat. What would be mixolydian flat six or Aeolian major? That's the fifth mode of E flat melodic minor. So I'm putting that lick in there that you taught me. Yeah, but you can also blues out on it. And it sounds fine, right? Because it's basically like this chromatic tension in B flat, of which blues has this like other kind of chromatic tension in B flat.
Yeah,
Right.
it's funny. That was one of those things, like theory-wise, that like I never really thought that deep about, but now anytime I hear it, I know exactly what to do. So thanks. Thanks
Awesome.
for that.
Hey, here's another thing. So the other so so the in that jazz sandwich, I have B flat blues as the sort of meat in the sandwich. And on one side, one piece of bread was that tonality, the Mixolydian flat six or the Aeolian major. That I think I said E flat melodic minor, which is that minor four relative to B flat.
The Beatles song.
The Beatles song, right. And I think of it as in B flat, it's the chromatic tension is north, it's up, and it resolves down.
Oh, okay. Oh, interesting.
So you can do blues around do you can do blues with that because it's just,
Well, not that, but
Yeah. So you can do like,
sure.
So you can do
Yeah.
even like
Oh, yeah, sure.
fill it in with chords
Yeah.
as much as you can.
Cool.
Yeah. So that's one side of the bread, right? That's the going down, I guess. And then the other thing everyone's probably heard, but not known what to do with it, is this thing, where it's the sharp four diminished. So that is the other side of the bread, right? The
Oh, okay. Oh, that again?
I'm doing an E diminished. Sorry. So what did I do? With the fourth in the melody.
Oh, wait. Okay, that it?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, that's I heard it. I've always heard it that way.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean?
Like not in a minute, something else. Oh, yeah. You could you totally do it like that. Yeah. So that's as if it's a half diminished.
This sounds more expensive.
Cooler. So this is like a half diminished, right?
Yeah. All right. So if you hear me play this on a gig, one of my cool things that I attempt to do, it's because I got it from Noel right here live at 4:34 p.m. on Facebook.
So that's actually a really popular thing in blues as well, and also jazz, right? So I think of this as an American chord progression, you know, right?
Mm-hmm.
The sharp four diminished, and similar to the lick you taught me, you know, where it's two chords that are really pointing to one sound.
Right.
I'm thinking of that E diminished to B flat over F, and that's this, you know, and then that to that. I'm thinking of that as another type of B flat sound, which is the sixth mode of D harmonic minor, which is the other piece of bread in the sandwich. And so if I were to isolate it over a B flat sound, it's B diminished to B flat.
Half diminished or whole diminished?
You can do fully diminished. So B flat, fully diminished.
B flat.
Yeah.
I just got a weird thing in the, okay. Yeah.
Weird thing, yeah. So that is the,
cool.
When it comes to B flat, it's like tension from the south.
Right.
It's from below.
Sick.
Yeah, so if you mix the two, what does that sound like? Sounds like blues.
Sure, all right.
So nice. On one side, you've got this thing, so you can play like stuff from D harmonic minor. Let's see if I can do, sense.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So that's like kind of fingering apart, like two, like you can play E flat melodic minor or D harmonic minor.
Uh-huh.
And then when you blend the two, it's like you can kind of fudge it with blues, B flat blues.
I like it.
You gonna try it?
I didn't bring a loop pedal, but
oh, okay.
But well, I can put one, I can plug it in.
Maybe you can do some product placement. What's your looper pedal of choice, Mark the Cherry?
Well, I'm still using the Ditto.
Yeah. Oh, the little guy.
Yeah, the little one. Yeah, here, hang on. Whoa. Okay. Let me make sure this is making noise.
So I can write that out for you if you guys.
Tell me the chords. Is the chords again?
Okay. So the in the sort of fifth mode of melodic minor one, it's C diminished to B flat, as in C diminished triad to B flat, and the different versions of that.
Oh.
And then on the D harmonic minor one, which is actually, if we think about it as B flat, it's B flat Lydian sharp 9, which is the sixth mode of D harmonic minor.
And you were playing B flat diminished?
B flat diminished to B major. B flat major.
B flat.
Yeah, or you could play this E diminished.
Spell that chord for the people, because you play, but your other voicing was really cool.
Oh, okay. So the voicing goes goes E,
uh-huh.
And then B flat, which is the flat 5, And then D flat, which is the double flatted seventh.
Yep.
And then E again. And then A, which is the fourth. So it's a, like a diminished, doesn't have the third in, but you could.
It.
You could put that in like as a melody note, you know.
That's great. And you were using that to replace the B flat diminished chord, correct?
Yeah, when you think about it, like you have B flat diminished or C sharp diminished or E diminished or G diminished. So, those all exist in harmonic minor.
And over this, you can play D harmonic minor?
Yeah. Yeah, are you going?
That's weird as hell. Okay.
Are you resolving to B flat major?
I will.
Okay.
Oh, I thought you meant you could play it over the whole thing. I was like,
oh, you could, yeah, but
well, it doesn't sound as good when I do it. Wow, I sound like crap in front of all the people. All right.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
Tune in now to see Mark Lettieri get a guitar lesson. This is awesome. Okay, cool. That's badass.
So we've got play this.
I was forgetting. Oh yeah. Oops. Nope.
Yeah. Put that in the looper. And you can do, so it's basically like, you can do this kind of thing. Like, you can apply A stuff to B flat stuff. You can do this.
Oh, neat. Okay.
Yeah. So, like, the tension is from the south. You know what I mean?
Weird.
Yeah, dude.
It's fun and slightly embarrassing.
You don't sound like crap. That's awesome, man.
Sweet.
All right. So I'm gonna scroll here and see if anyone has any questions.
I've been checking to see a few things. No one's left. That's good.
Oh, nice.
I don't know. You guys have any questions?
Well, there's a lot of questions. Look at this.
Maybe mine's behind yours or something. I think mine is.
Oh, I have comments. A lot of comments here. I can't see all the comments. I could only see. Let's see. Man.
There's a leaf blower.
There's 39 comments, but I only see the last four. So.
Leaf blower's in the key of B flat.
Larry asks, how does Noel? How did Noel have time for learning all this stuff? No, how did I have time for my wife while learning all this stuff?
Damn, that's a personal question.
It is a personal question, but that's okay. I've been fortunate to, my regular gigs that I have to make money, where it's like, honey, I'm going out to work right now, and I get to hang out with you at Daystar, and then I get to hang out with all these awesome students at UNT and talk about all this stuff. So basically I'm thinking about this stuff all day and getting paid for it. So
dream job.
Yeah, it's my dream job. Yeah, it was my dream job.
Oh yeah, right. Now you have to do this.
No, I've enjoyed it, whatever. Greg says, this is awesome. I hope this is being recorded. It is being recorded. Wait a minute. I guess I'll just let it go up. I should have started recording it, maybe I could put it up on YouTube or something later, but...
Oh.
Never mind.
Cool.
Anyway, let's see if I can see if anyone else has any other questions. I'm sorry for all those who've left comments. I can't see any... Oh, hey, Matt. It was nice to meet you at NAMM as well. I'm sorry about... He had a bit of bad luck at NAMM, didn't he? It was Matt who got his car.
Oh yeah. Oh hey, Matt. Man, he did a great live stream the other day where he was playing all kinds of solo guitar stuff. It was very good.
Nice.
Yeah, it was rad. He had this like octave pedal, or I think it was an R, one of those where it just transposed the bottom two strings. It was super cool.
Oh, nice. Just the bottom two strings. That's cool.
I think so. Yeah.
Maybe hey, George Anderson. He asked a really good question. Can you discuss the triads within the diminished chords with examples if possible? Oh, my goodness. Yeah, there's so many. So
what I get a beer?
So what I was talking about was the four different diminished chords that exist in harmonic minor as opposed to the symmetrical diminished. I have been gravitating towards what I call tonal diminished instead of symmetrical diminished lately, because especially in like in, you know, tune in jazz tunes or whatever, or blues, the diminished has a function apart, like not like a synthetic sound, not like separated off from the rest of the chords, but actually included in the rest of the chord. So if I have like E diminished going to B flat, the various triads that you can do within, say if you're thinking of this in B flat Lydian sharp 9, which is the sixth mode of D harmonic minor. Sorry, that's a mouthful. I'm thinking of that as a two. Of D harmonic minor. And so anything you can do over that, if I were to just, you know, loop that flavor. So I can do any triad that exists in D harmonic minor. So D minor, obviously. And then E diminished, obviously. And then F augmented. And then G minor. And then A major. B flat major. Sorry, let me try that again. So B flat major. And then fine, there's another diminished, which would be C sharp diminished. Yeah, that's why I love practicing with a looper pedal, because you can kind of see here how it blends, how it kind of jives with it. Anyway, having a looper pedal really changed the way I play and teach.
What did we do before those?
Good question.
Mark Cuthbertson says that Mark, I don't know, what's his last name? Mark Cuthbertson.
Is it possible to not do any of this?
Yes.
Oh, come on, Mark.
No, it's cool, man.
A major, Matt. Goofball.
You can go. You can go like this. You can go. You can do that.
Yeah, you totally could.
You can do this.
Jesse's girl. Yeah.
You could do this. You could do, yeah, you go, and you could even play it wrong, like I just did. You could do a lot. That's not what Noel just did.
Yeah. Hey, Matt says time feel stuff. I don't know if that's a question
or a nope, statement. It's just an it's like sandwiches. When you're hungry, time feels stuff. Okay, well, go ahead, Professor.
No, you start. Oh, well, someone. I saw another question that was talk about your favorite You know, it's gone now. I can't scroll down and see what it was. I can't. It's so weird.
Did they disappear after a while?
You know what? I'm gonna go to my own page, and I still can't see it. Dang it. All right. It won't let me scroll up. I think probably because it's going. It's in real time.
Right. That whole thing.
Anyway. Okay, so Matt says, some time examples.
Why don't you talk about that crazy stuff you were doing the other day with Pass the Stupid Butter.
Okay. Yeah, you want to do the different versions of 2 against 3 and the different versions of 4 against 3?
Good. Okay. Go for it.
Ooh. Chad has a great question.
For real, your book.
But yeah, let's talk about time stuff for a second.
Well, no, I actually can't. Noel can do it way better, so I'll just have him do it. otherwise, if we could play in real time, I would comp for you, but we can't do that.
You know, Chad offers a really good question, actually, because what I did say was that in, you know, B-flat blues is kind of fudging the divide between the D harmonic minor and the E-flat melodic minor. Where B flat is home base, so in the context of like a B flat blues progression, like people always ask, like, oh, what happens if the piano player is comping this other sound and you're playing this other sound, and it's like, you know, it's okay sometimes, like different chromaticism for a limited number of time, stretch of time, is fine. It's perfectly fine. You're gonna get, you know, gonna get a little bit of crunchiness, but. I kind of justify it by saying it's you know, kind of has the blues vibe. So if I so if I just vamped on this
B flat 7,
yeah. You could probably convince someone that you're playing the right stuff if you go either or, play D flat harmonic minor, or E flat melodic minor. I probably wouldn't want to go back and forth in a short amount of time because your ear would sort of get used to one flavor. And then,
hear you. Oh, you turned it off. Sorry, I was trying to play.
It's still going. I think it gates it.
It sounds kind of cool.
Yeah.
I don't know about E flat harmonic. What was the other?
Oh, E flat melodic minor?
E flat melodic. D harmonic minor sounds cooler
too. So here's my point. Like, I feel like your ear gets used to one.
Let me do a loop so we just and, like I have
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, and then I'll turn it off. Okay. Well, here. So we said D harmonic minor. I like that.
It's pretty sweet, yeah. Now, if you switch to the other one, if you switch to E flat, melodic minor, now it'll sound a little bit weird at first, but you'll get used to it.
That's the Luther Vandross, like, yeah, you know.
My wife loves Luther Vandross.
That sounds cool.
Try the E-flat melodic minor.
Okay.
Yeah.
I still like the better.
Got it.
But that's just me. Melodic minor works cool.
Yeah, I think both are neat. I have this analogy that having a glass of orange juice after brushing your teeth, it's pretty nasty, like right after.
Yeah.
But you get used to it.
Oh, shit. Huh. Do you ever, like, view through, like, one of the things I was talking about with a student yesterday was, like, viewing the minor pentatonic scale as just, like, anchor points between the 1, the 3, the 5, and the 7, and then everything else in between is, like, fair game, as long as you kind of, like, think within these kind of like a roadmap, I guess. Does that make sense? Am I the only person that thinks like this?
Explain.
So like here, 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 and here is like sort of like your target. Like if you don't want to get lost in anything, like you can think of like those as like your spots. But then all the notes in between are like fair chromatic game for phrasing, as long as you eventually quote something that's involving the 3rd or the 5th or the 7th.
Okay.
I don't know.
Sure.
That's how
sure.
I think. I mean, that's how I think about, like, people are like, well, how do you, you know, play chromatic-y blues things? And that's what I think about.
Okay.
You know, like, like stuff like that, like, you know what I mean, like taking like the using the flat five as like almost like a pivot note or something.
Sure. That's beautiful. I love that.
That's great. B flat sucks on guitar.
I know, but horn players exist, so that's why we know it.
But why?
Yeah, man, there's so many ways to skin a cat, you know, like if we get... Mm-hmm. So what I think is neat is to instead of, I mean, I love the way you play, obviously, so I'm not trying to correct you.
No, please.
But
probably what I'm doing is wrong.
No, it's not wrong. Like, no, the world will kill me if I try to make you play any different. But what I think is neat is to, like, separate the different types of chromaticism. Like, you've got the chromaticism that is derived from D harmonic minor, and then you've got this other type of chromaticism that's derived from E flat melodic minor, and you know, within that sort of universe of that new tonality, you can do other stuff that relate. So if I was doing the say the E flat melodic minor stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
I can do flat melodic minor,
cool.
Play like a,
okay.
Which is like a augmented major 7, you know, major 7 sharp 5 arpeggio. To the 4, which is Lydian dominant.
Oh yeah.
You know.
The 4 of E flat melodic minor, right?
Yeah, so
cool. Sweet.
So that inspires a whole nother sort of group of licks that you can come up with that, you know, in the context of B flat, it kind of sounds bluesy, right?
Oh, just cut out. But yeah, okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Sweet.
So yeah, so it's still like you said, you're using your ear to like say, you're still gravitating to one of the chord tones, mm-hmm. and the in-between stuff is fair game.
Right.
Which is true. I'm just saying, like, okay, well, just as an experiment, let's not say all of them are fair game all the time. Just like maybe these three, or, you know.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's funny. Like, I do a lot of things probably the wrong way, but,
nope.
You know what I mean? Like, I always view, I think I said this in some other class at some point. I was talking about playing Cro-Mags. I was like, you know, where you normally put your fingers, don't put them there. It's like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm always like just trying to experiment, even with like just learning how different single notes sound over each chord. And trying to figure out like a way, like if you end up in a weird spot, to get out of it.
Right.
Yeah, that's a good,
like,
awesome.
Like, especially like I always end up, if you hit like a minor six over like a seven, it's like, oh, what do we do? You know what I mean? Yeah, E-flat melodic minor. There it is.
Yeah.
Theory's fun, kids.
Yeah, right.
Explain it to you. Yeah. Otherwise, you just put your fingers where you're not supposed to. Like,
yeah, I guess for me, the theory was neat because it was a way for me to put that muscle memory stuff to use.
I see.
Like, it's like, oh, I know it's E-flat melodic minor, so I, you know, my hand knows how to do that all over the neck because I had teachers right. that made me do it.
Perfect, yeah. Cool.
Because I think the muscle memory is a really interesting study.
Do you find yourself playing, like, because you have that kind of muscle memory, do you find yourself playing the same kind of phrases over and over again?
Well, if I force myself to think,
how do you get at it? Like, for people, you know, because we all do that. It's like I have licks or whatever.
Yeah.
Just because my fingers would feel good in a specific place, you know.
So if I'm thinking of, if my mind is able to say, okay, I'm going to derive licks from E flat melodic minor, you know, if I'm thinking of the one, yeah, I might repeat myself a lot. So maybe I'll think of the two and then the three and then the four and then the five and then the six and then the seven. And I've got a different set of licks depending on what I'm thinking about.
Interesting.
If that makes any sense. And then, but then the glue would be the muscle memory just in the key.
Okay. Cool.
So I don't know if I repeat myself too much. I spent so much time
here it
putting
is.
It down on paper. So when you write,
you guys, now you know, now there's a toilet paper shortage. So if you need something to help you get through these times, Noel has a fantastic book, two books.
Yeah, and Mark has some fantastic albums too.
I don't have any books. I never learned to read.
Some albums
from Wayne's World. Well, the albums are good for coasters if you want to like put your coffee mug, you know, on one of the records that's like the perfect size, just like that, you know. Oh, this has been heating up. Weird. I got this coffee heating, like a little hot plate that you can put your coffee on, and the weight of the mug will turn it on. It's pretty awesome.
Nice.
Yeah. Let's see. Has anybody said? Oh, theory is fun, kids. Yeah, sometimes.
Great and honest context, says Danielle. Okay, awesome.
Yeah, thanks for tuning in, friends.
Yeah. Yeah, so anyway, I gotta teach an actual student now.
Wait a minute, what was this? Do I owe you money?
No, I mean, I meant to say, like, you're not a student of it. Anyway, everybody, thanks for tuning in. And Mark, thanks for hanging. Yeah,
thanks for the guitar lesson, man. This was fun.
No, likewise.
Hope the audio is all right. Well, I guess we'll figure that out. I'm going to go back and watch it and see what I can do to make it better.
Cool. Hey, Corey says, what are some tips on getting comfortable with new scales and keys so it doesn't sound patterny or scaly?
Hmm.
For example, oh, it's gone.
I got some. I still have it because my thing is slow.
Okay.
What are some tips on getting? So here's what I do sometimes. And even if it's not, you can do this with old scales too. I just try to make sure I can play as many things as possible up and down the neck on one string at a time. Because then I find myself like, I don't ever think about anything in a box that way. You know what I mean? Like, especially like with guitar players, like, you know, we're in B flat, right? For most of the lesson today. Like, I have a tendency to be like, okay, this is where I can play a B flat. So I'm going to play all my things right here. You know what I mean? But probably if I spent more time like thinking about where all the possible intervals and stuff were for the particular scale up and down the neck, I wouldn't feel like, you know, anchored to write in this position or this position. You know what I mean? Do you ever have that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, cool.
I wasn't listening. Oh. One of my the student I'm supposed to teach right now is texting me, so I better go actually.
Okay. All right.
But dude, thank you. I'll go back and listen to your answer and then
be a jerk.
I'm so sorry. I'm being a jerk.
All right.
All right, love you, everybody.
Bye.
See ya.
See you, friends. Time feels tough. Okay, yeah. Well, go ahead, Professor.
No, you start.